Hi guys, this is Sushant, Kochar. Today we are going to talk about at what body fat percentage your abs would show up. The number is 10%. So, first of all, we are talking about males over here. The females can add 7 to 8% body fat to the number that we are talking for males. So for example, around 10% body fat, the abs of a male should show up. So for a female, it should be around 17 to 18% body fat. So I talked about this in my previous video that you add 7 to 8 to the male fat percentage to get the corresponding number for the female fat percentage. Okay, so around 10% body fat your abs would show up. For some it can show up around 7 to 8% body fat, for some it can show up around 12 to 13% body fat, depends on the body. But let's say you are at 10% body fat and you have started to see your blurred abs. So if you go towards 7 to 8% body fat, your abs visibility would get clear as you get rid of the fat on the body. As you go from 10 to 11 or 12% body fat, your abs would start to get more blur, so because you are gaining fat on the body, so that is how it works. And around 70 to 18% body fat, the female would should have the abs being showing up. So for some, it can the number can be 15 or 16, for some, it can be 18 or so, but they would see as much as a female's body can show the abs, okay. And now, there are some people think that they need to do a lot of crunches or ab exercises to get the visibility of abs, to get the abs. I have talked about this in my previous videos multiple times, but I'll explain it again. So it is not the exercise that is going to make the abs visible. It is getting rid of the fat on top of those abs that would get the abs visible. So just like removing the dust from the book would make you get able to see the words that are written on it. So that is how it works. You have the muscle in your belly. For some it can be developed, for some it can be underdeveloped. Developed muscle is bigger muscle, stronger muscle, but it is still there. Even if it is not visible, it is still there. You have to get it visible by reducing the fat percentage. Okay. Yeah, don't run behind abs. A lot of people think that abs is a necessity of life, or health is defined by abs. If you don't have abs, you are not healthy. If you have abs, you are healthy. And a lot of people run behind abs for the aesthetics purposes. So you don't need to run behind abs for health, at least. Because even if you don't have abs, you are healthy. Abs is not a necessity to be healthy. Now, our ancestors have lived long lives, like 100 plus years, and many of those ancestors did not. I think majority of those ancestors wouldn't have visible abs. So, visible abs is not a necessary condition for health. Okay, good health. Skinny guys, especially the guys who have low muscle mass, they should not run behind abs. They should first try to gain muscle mass, then they should try to get their abs visible. So they should not go for too low body fat percentage. What they should do is they should come around 14, 15, or 16% body fat, and if they are obese, they should come around this body fat and then gain muscle. As they gain muscle, they'll gain some fat, then again come down to this body fat percentage range, 14, 15, or 16%, and then again gain some muscle, and then come down to this percentage. When they think they have significant amount of muscle, then they can try going down to 13, 12, or 10% body fat and get their abs visible. Similar is the case for the skinny females. You can do the same procedure for the fat range, fat percentage range of 21 to 23% or so get rid of the fat, come to this fat percentage range, gain muscle, again come back to this fat percentage range, repeat the procedure till you feel that you have significant amount of muscle, and then come down to 20, 19, 18% body fat. You can think about going down to that fat percentage. So this was about when your abs show up. I also wanted to mention, see, if it was not clear for you in this on this board because my marker gave up. I just wanted to mention that this has not been written over here specially for you. It has been written over here for me, so that in case if I forget anything, I can see on the board and recall it. So in most of my videos, you can just listen to what I'm saying and you can understand the whole concept. Only a few videos, very few videos where I'm showing some sort of calculation, then you might need to look at the board. Otherwise, I have mentioned this earlier as well, that you don't need to look at the board, just listen to what I'm saying. The board is mainly for me to remember everything. If you like the video, please like, comment, and share. I will see you in the next video. Bye bye.